go.
I've had this steel for month and a half now, 2 months. It's been doing great, but it's time for a maintenance. I have to change the oil, clean the air filter, clean the mower bed underneath here, and just give it a good blowout for the air compressor. But as any good owner, I will first have to read the manual because I'm not a mechanic. After the first 5 hours or 1 month, you gotta change the oil. There's some grease nipples on the front axle here. The oil you can change here and fill it here. Check the tires. I have one tire where there is a metal piece in it, so I'll try to fix that as well. And for the rest, just clean everything out. Clean the air filter, which is on top. This is perfect. It's made for it. Woo, this is hot. I mowed the grass before I change the oil. When the oil is hot, it's a lot better. And the bottle should be enough. There should be around 1.6, 1.7 liters on it. As you can see, the oil is not clear anymore, so it's time to change it. Okay. This is the one that needs to go on, or the one from steel, doesn't matter. The most important is this number. The difference in viscosity of the oil is amazing. The hot oil was just coming out like water, and this one is more goopy. It's a little trick I learned is when you put new oil on, it's clear oil. You can't see it very well on this clear dipstick. You just put your dipstick in, take a rag, white one, and you put it next to it, and you roll it, and then you can see the level you're on. I'm gonna give it a quick clean with the air hose and then grease the front nipples, and then we'll have a look at the mower deck. The only thing that bothers me a little bit with this mower is for the price they could have included an hour meter, because they're talking about after 5 hours you have to do this, that, after 20 hours you have to do this and that, and they didn't include it. So I'll have to get one aftermarket or something. Here is a little grease nipple here and on the other side as well. So when you grease something, you have to see the grease coming out, then it's okay. You push out the old grease.
Oh, the tire bit.
I haven't done this before, so we'll see how it goes. Piece of metal. Well, this is all quite new to me. Locate the puncture. Okay. Easy enough. And put some lubrication. Okay. Then we have this part. Out you go. So, what do you want me to do is, you want me to push this down. Okay. It's not releasing air. Okay. I need to get a new one because it's not measuring correctly, but at least I can put air on it, so. It's holding air. I'm happy. Oh, perfect. Perfect. The best thing of all, this little kit I bought was maybe like 20 euros. So if it saves me from bringing the tire somewhere else to fix it, well worth it. Done. I moved the trailer from in the long grass here. It's a better spot and I don't have to look at it from the house all the time. I'm well pleased with the tire repair. Saves me a lot of trouble taking the tire off and bringing it somewhere.
There it is. This one is lodged in there somewhere, so I'll have to get underneath. I want to remove this cover. There's one bolt here. Hopefully I can do it like this. And then I can look underneath. That's where the snare is, the belt that drives the mower blades. But I want to see if there's pieces of the sticks still left in there rubbing against the belt. Aha! Look at this. It was time. It was time. Okay, just a little recap, because sometimes I'm all over the place. I don't do it with scripts or anything, it just blurts out of my mind. This is a steel RT4112 S set. Bought it 1.5-2 months ago. It's been working a lot. First I strammed the place, then I used this one. It's been flawless. The only part that's not aligned anymore is the hood. There's two screws missing at the front from all the bouncing, I guess. It's not all straight here. So someone who has a beautiful lawn already probably doesn't have that problem. But for the rest, it's been great. I just did maintenance on it. The front grease nipples, just the general blowing, the air filter, cleaned it out. The oil has been changed, and for the rest, it keeps on running. So for me, this is still a win. We'll see how it goes. Maybe in 5-6 months or after the winter, I will do another update on it. The only thing I have to do is take off the mowing deck and grind the blades so they're sharpened again. I'll show you that in the next video. Good morning. Today I'm gonna install the bracket for the internet, the Starlink. We have Starlink for internet. It's always in the garden, so I always have to move it around when I have to work or mow the grass. So I want to put it here and then put Wi-Fi on top of it as well. I'll run a cable from the new barn through the old barn up in the attic of the house and down to the living room where our computer is. Okay, because these are hollow bricks, so I'm gonna use some injection mortar to get my plugs in securely and then screw it all down. All done. It's been fixed 8 times, so I could probably hang my weight off it. The next step, but that's not for now, will be to mount the Starlink on top and the Wi-Fi extender just beneath it. But first I'm gonna do all the cabling and everything. So once I move the Starlink, we have internet inside. Because if I move it now, we don't have anything until I do the cable.
Oh boy. What have you discovered, Odin? So you know you can open them now, huh?
You saw me hanging up the mount for the Starlink. The cable is gonna run from the blue barn, it's gonna run up on the metal railing from the roof, then it's gonna go inside the old barn to the corner over there, and then from the corner I'm gonna go to the attic of the house, and from the attic I'll go to the back and then down to the living room where the computer is, and I'll put another Wi-Fi access point there so we have Wi-Fi in the house. So it sounds simple, but it is quite a run. I think it's 60, 70 meters. So let's have some fun. How sturdy are you? Let's find out when we get up here. Okay. I want to try to get inside the old barn, not making a hole, but just going through the roof. And then the other side, where I have to go out to go to the house, I think I can go the same way without making a hole, because there's already an electricity cable there. And to go into the attic of the house itself, the farmhouse, I can go through the roof as well, because these are old roofs. There is no isolation or anything inside, so it's just open. This is Cat 6 outdoor wire Ethernet cable. Let's unspool it first, because if I get this tangled, it's not gonna be a happy day. Corner over there, that's where the cable should come out. You saw me on the other side. I'm gonna have a look if there's an opening in there. And victory! I'm gonna run it along the roof beam all the way till the end. Go out there and go inside the farmhouse on the attic. I gotta be careful because there is nobody on the other side. So I gotta feel it if I'm not kinking the cable.
I'll have to go outside and check on the cable once in a while. But it's better to do this carefully than destroy the cable. Let's put it over this truss, the other truss, the other, there's four trusses. See the outside. I just had a look outside where I'll have to go in the house. Think I still need some more cable. I'm gonna try to pull it from here, which works. Someone likes me today. Let's try again, these last few meters. Here is where we came out of the old barn. And here is where we'll have to go in the attic. That other cable you see is not being used. I'll remove it. Let's go up the attic and see if we can find it. It's starting to rain anyways. Okay, I found it. I'm gonna go outside, release the cable from the gutter. I tied it off there, and I'm gonna pull it inside here to the other side. Okay, very good. There, up here is the attic. In the corner I have the cable already. Gonna make a hole up there, make a hole down here. And that's where the living room is, where the computer and everything is. So I'll run the cable like this. Just for now, it doesn't matter, it's temporary. I don't see lights. That's not a good sign. Unless these walls are not the same thickness, but normally they are. Okay, I removed a plank over there, and now I found a hole that's full of newspapers and stuff like that, so, which doesn't matter for now. What matters most is I can get the cable through. I'll put a little piece of wood back and done.
Yeah.
Next, I'm in the attic of the new barn. Attach it to this rail, bring it to the other side, and then down. That's where the internet will go. Done for the day. That's what I wanted to do, is get the cable pulled through. Tomorrow I'm gonna put a wooden board on the wall where I can mount all the stuff on. Stuff for the solar, the batteries, stuff for the internet, so it's all nice and clean. We are in the new barn. You know, the new barn, it's not that new, but still it's newer than the old barn. I'm gonna put wooden boards on this wall in the corner. I think it will be the best location where I will put the Victron system and everything for the Ethernet, and I can run a cable from here to where I will put the Starlink that you saw me putting up, the metal pipe at the corner. And so that is what I will be doing today. I'm gonna cut the plywood. I've bought two of them plywood to size, place them on here. Is this the definite location? I think so, but it's always difficult. I've been living here 3 months, you think about it all. It's possible it gets moved to the old barn once that one is renovated, because it's a bit closer to the house, so the runs for electricity and all that is a bit shorter then. We'll see. 90% sure, we'll keep it here. Let's bring it at 2 meters. Right, 2 meters. Always like to keep it a little bit off the floor for moisture and stuff like that. Ideally, I should support the other side to get a cleaner cut. Time to make a little bit of dust. The concrete here sticks out a little bit too much. This is okay. Here a little bit. Thank you.
I'm in the caravan. You've seen it before. I'm gonna take out the Vectron system, the battery 5 kilowatts, and the Vectron Multiplus 2, who can supply 5 kilowatts of power as well. It's too big for the caravan anyways, so I'm gonna take it out. And if we sell the caravan and the next owner wants a similar system, I can put it in, or he can put it in himself. The most of the cabling will stay, and for the caravan a 3 kilowatt system or something like that should be enough. Well, the inverter anyways. The battery is maximum under the seat that you can get from Pilantec, and that fits this 5 kilowatts, which is plenty, but the inverter can be less. Okay, let's disassemble it. This is the Vectron Multiplus. I installed it on its side because there was no other way to get it in. Then we have a MPPT solar charger here, which I didn't connect, and I will not be using this for the other array I have. I will choose a bigger one. So this one I'm gonna sell or leave it in the caravan for the next owner. Let's set up here. Okay. These batteries weigh up. I think this one is 40 kilograms. When I put it in, I put a extra piece of plywood so it would all be strong. This is staying, of course. The brackets still have to go. And then here was a big fuse that goes to the battery bank. So it's quite a simple system, this Vectron system. Okay. This is a small Vectron solar charger, which is perfect for here in the caravan. If you put some solar panels on top of it, this one will do just fine.